Today, Krishna speaks about Kshetra and Kshetranya to Arjuna. The matter in which we exist and the consciousness which stays in the matter. About these two, clearly explains. All of us are some way or other, whether you understand or not, whether you experience it or not, related to this whole universe. The consciousness, which is the root cause, they say Adi Mula, not only the origin, and it is cause. Please understand. Origin and cause. From where it comes and on which it stays. The whole universe, the universal consciousness, is the space in which we all happen. Here Krishna explains about the wave and the ocean. Ocean is universal consciousness. Whatever words you may use, God or Atman, Buddhists use Nirvana, or Vedantists say Brahman, and Muslims say Allah, whatever names you may use. But all these things means the same, the cosmic energy, universal consciousness. Krishna reveals the secrets of wave. We are all waves, and this whole is ocean. Krishna reveals the secrets about the wave and about the ocean and how you can experience the oneness with the ocean. Our only problem in the life is somehow we forgot we are part of the ocean. We forgot that we belong to ocean. We forgot we belong to Kshetranya. The word Kshetranya means the consciousness who is cause for the field to function. Kshetra means field. Kshetranya means knower of the field. Kshetra means body. Kshetranya means consciousness which knows that it has got body. Your consciousness is Kshetranya. This matter, body is Kshetra. Here, today is revealing all the secrets which is related to Kshetra and Kshetranya. If you don't know the secrets of Kshetranya, Kshetra will start acting as if he is the owner. For example, a small example, you get a new car and you sit in the car, start driving. Suddenly after 10 minutes you realize you don't know how to stop it. You don't know how to stop it. If you don't know how to stop it, you are not driving the car. Car is driving you. Same way, you get into this mind, get into this body, you start living. Suddenly at one point, you see, you find, you are not able to stop your body or mind. It goes as it wants. If you have the habit of drinking coffee morning 7 o'clock, you don't have to remember by seeing the watch. The moment it becomes 7, inside coffee, the bell will ring. And if you are habituated for smoking, the moment that mood comes, any situation related to that mood comes, immediately you feel like smoking. The whole life, your whole system is not under your control. The body and mind starts living instead of you experiencing or enjoying the body and mind. Body and mind are leaving you. Instead of you driving the car, car is driving you. Same way, you get into this car, body and mind. When you are not able to control them as you want, when you are not able to handle them as you want, be very clear, you are not driving body and mind. Body and mind are driving you. You are not the owner of body and mind. Body and mind are your owners. That is what today I have given. That's why I gave the topic, eat before you are eaten.